Hello there. In this video lecture, we are trying to learn what is the free body diagram for the parallel forces in a plane. So as we know that the parallel forces, when we are taking the line of actions, they are not going to be intersect anywhere. Throughout the process, they are going to be maintain the same distance between the two forces. So here, I had taken the one problem that's going to be a bar, AB, of length 2L and negligible weight rest on two roller supports C and D. Placed at a distance L apart, the bar supports two vertical loads as shown. For the reactions at the supports to be equal, that means RA and RB are going to be equal, find the distance X of the end A of the bar from the support C. So this is the question. So that I am going to be converting into the diagram here. So here the bar AB of length 2L has given, and the rest on the two roller supports, that's we are going to be taking C and the D, and the distance between these two is going to be the L apart. The bar is going to be supports two vertical loads as shown. So that means I am going to give here the two vertical loads at the end A and the end B. That's going to be 2W at the end A and 3W at end B. So then in this case, we need to find out the distance between the rollers C and the end A. That's going to be the X distance we need to find out. To find this X value, the first we need to draw the free body diagram. That's what we are discussing in this present the video lecture. And next, the roller C and the roller D are going to be I have taken. And the next, we are taking the loads over here. The load is going to be 2W. I am going to be replacing with the vertically downward direction arrow, that is the 2W. And similarly, at B is going to be 3W load that I am going to show with the arrow, because it is going to be subjected to the gravitational force that is acting vertically downward direction. That's going to be 3W. And next, what I'm going to do, I'm going to be removing the supporter C, then I'm going to show with the reaction force RC. So that I have removed that, then I have shown with the reaction force which is acting vertically upward directions, because 2W and 3W forces are acting in the downward direction. It means that I'm assuming the AB body is going to be trying to move vertically downward direction, but we need to keep the body in the equilibrium condition. So that's I have shown with the RC in the upward direction. And similarly, I'm going to be removing the support D, and then I'm going to be show with the reaction force vertically upward direction, that is the RD at the D support. At the same time, we do have the dimensional properties, like the distance between AB is the 2L and between the C and the D, the point is going to be the L, and we need to find out the X distance from the point A to C. This way, we are going to be draw the free body diagrams. Once we are going to be draw the free body diagrams, we are going to be applying the equations of equilibrium. So in this case, the equations of equilibriums, and we are going to be see here, and the load, that means the force acting at A and the point at C. So there we can see I have drawn the line of actions. So once I'm going to be draw the line of actions, they are not going to be intersecting each other. At the same time, the point D also I have drawn, at the B also I have drawn. These, any of these forces, they are not intersecting, but they are parallel to each other, but they are going to be not in the same direction. They are going to be unlike forces, there we can see. So then we can say the system is going to be subjected to the parallel forces in a respective plane. This is called the coplanar parallel forces. So then I'm going to be applying the equations of equilibrium. As we know that the algebraic sum of the forces in x direction is equal to zero. Similarly, algebraic sum of the vertical forces is equal to zero, and the moments acting at any point of these members are is equal to zero. So that means the summation of the components of the moments components of these forces are equal to zero. By using this one, we are going to be find out the x distance from point A to C. So this way we have solved the free body diagram. The next I have taken one more problem, that is going to be three beams AB, BC and CD are hinged at their ends and the loaded and supported as shown in figure. Determine the reactions at the points A, E, F and the D. So now I am going to be keeping in the pictorial view. So there we can see here the first, the three beams he mentioned, the first beam is going to be the AB I have taken here. So that's going to be AB. So next beam is going to be the BC that I have shown. So at the same time, one more condition we need to satisfy. This is the beam AB and the beams BC are going to be hinged at point B. So next I'm going to be taking the CD beam and then I'm going to be applying here. The load is going to be, as for the given data here, is going to be 1000 newtons is going to be acting vertically downward direction to the BC member. And similarly, another load is going to be acting at the 1000 newtons at the point C. And similarly, the CD, I have taken the beam and hinged at the C. So then 1000 newtons load is going to be acting. And here is that part. And similarly, and at the end A and some other points, there is the supports are there. So then we can see at A, there is a triangle supports we do have taken. This is also hinged part. And the next, we do have the roller support, which is supporting the beam AB at E. And similarly, there is the roller support at F, which is going to be existed in the CD beam. And similarly, at D, there is going to be another connection there that's going to be hinged R and supported at G. So this is what will happen. So then these are the body has given. We need to determine the reactions at the points A, E, F and the D. We need to do reactions. So first I am going to be taking individually. First I am going to be taking the CD, next BD, next AD beams I am going to be taking. If I am going to be taking the AB, then the problem is that there is unknown forces are there where we are unable to calculate it. And similarly the BC also. That's why the first we know there is 1002 loads are acting at the point C as well as F. So then what will happen? I can find out the reaction forces at F, at D also, because the two unknowns easily we can calculate from this part. So then I'm going to be taking, here is the diagram. So these are the dimensional properties. From AB is going to be the 2.5 meters, but A and E, the distance is going to be 1.5 meters. And similarly, the B to the point, the 1000 newtons is going to be 1.25 meters and the total BC length is going to be 2.5 meters. And similarly, there is a distance between the F as well as that load is going to be acting and the D is going to be 1.5 meters and the total beam length is going to be 2.5 meters. So now I'm going to take a free body diagram at CD because we know the known parameters are available. That means the loaded values are available so that we can calculate easily. So in this case, this is the diagram I have separated from that AB, BC and CD beams and I have taken only the CD and the same diametrical properties and the similarly that load properties also we are going to show. Though I am going to be draw the free body diagram for this CD. There this is going to be the CD, that is going to be, then I separated the hinges and then the 1000 newton load already has given another 1000 newtons load which is at a distance of 1.5 meters from the D end. So next that is the F, the roller supports, I am removing that part, I am showing with the reaction forces which is acting vertically upward direction. And similarly at point D there is a supporter is there, so that I am going to be removing and showing with the reaction forces acting vertically in the downward direction. These are the assumptions. It is not mandatory that we need to assume only in the upward direction, because at the point C the loads are acting in the 1000 newtons and the 1000 newtons. In this case what will happen, at the point F there is a fulcrum is going to be generating, that's the point D is trying to move in the upward direction. So we need to apply the restriction forces in the downward direction, that's why I given. At the point C also I have separated from the BC beam, that's why I have to show with the reaction forces. This way we are going to be calculating the reaction forces at the C, F, at the D, and by using the equations of equilibrium, that's going to be F of x equal to 0, F of y equal to 0, and the moments at any one point we are considering that is equal to sum of the moments at that point. So this way we are going to be solving the free body diagrams and then we are calculating the unknown parameters. Once we are going to be calculating the CD beam parameters, then we are shifting to the BCD link we are going to be taking. So then in this case, this is the original diagram what we had given in the beam. Now I am going to be removing the supports and I am going to show. So most of the time the reactions are coming at B, at F as well as at D. From the previous session CD, we have calculated the RF as well as the RD. So that in this case only we need to calculate the RB. So that's we are going to be seeing here. So the first I am going to be taking the beam B, C, D. Then I have shown with the forces are acting on these members, the same geometrical properties we have used to show these loads. And the next RF is going to be there, that's we are removing and showing with the reaction forces. And similarly at the B, there is a, we have separated AB beam, and that means we need to show with the reaction forces. These reaction forces are going to be restricting the motion of a body in a respective direction. We are assuming that the body B, C, D is going to be moving in the downward directions. That's why we have shown. And similarly at the D, already we told that it is trying to move in the upward direction. Reaction forces are coming in the downward directions that we have shown. So it may not be necessary that these forces are going to be acting in the downward. You can take in the upward direction also by assuming that the body is moving in the downward direction. So then we are going to be using the equilibrium equations, that is the sigma F is equal to zero, horizontal forces. In this case, we don't have any horizontal forces, only we do have the vertical forces. So that's sigma F of y equal to zero, and the moments we have taken at any point, so that we can calculate the RB very easily. So the next one is going to be the free body diagram. So in this case, the beam ABCD, we do have taken the total length of the beam. And this is going to be the total length we do have. So that is the given figure. So now I'm going to be removing all the supports, and that I'm going to be show with the reaction forces. So this, in this case, AB, BC, and the C, the beam I have shown here. At the B and the C, there is a hinged position only. We are not separated because already we have calculated these things separately. So next I'm going to show with the loads are acting on that beam. Next one at A, that support is there, that I'm going to be removing and showing with the reaction forces in the vertically upward direction. And similarly at E, there on the beam AB, so there is a reaction forces I'm going to show with the vertically upward directions. And similarly, there is going to be F, that already is vertically acting in the upward direction. And similarly at point D, there is a support we are removed and showing with the reaction forces. This way, already we do have calculated RD, RF in the previous session, and now we can calculate the RA and RE very easily by using this free body diagrams, that using the equilibrium equation, sigma F of X is equal to zero. In this case, there is no horizontal forces, only the vertical forces are there, the summation of the forces are equal to zero. So then the moments we are going to be taking either at A or at E, so that we can nullify one force, which is going to be for the moments is nothing but the force into perpendicular distance. In this case, if I am going to take the moments at A, so that there is no distance between the point A to the RA, which is passing to the same point, then automatically that force is not going to be generating any kind of moments, but force is going to be as it is, so that we can calculate the RE. This way we are going to be solving the unknown parameters by using the free body diagrams. So here, what is the outcome from this parallel forces we are used to draw the free body diagram? So in this case, we are able to understand what's the free body diagram, right? The free body diagrams are nothing but we are removing the supports and opposing the motion of your body, or we are restricting the motion of your body by providing the constraints, so that the restrictions are going to be here, we are showing in terms of the reaction forces. Then what is the importance and the function of the free body diagram? The importance here is that we do the mathematical equations, and then we need to restrict the motion of a free body. So then what will happen? The reaction forces we are going to be show. That's the way we are going to be finding the function of a free body diagram. The third one is how to assume the motion of the objects. This the motion of the object means we are providing the reaction forces to that particular moving the supports. That by assuming the motion of the body in a respective direction, we need to restrict that motion. Then we are applying the reaction forces. Next one, develop the restrictions to the motion. This is also the same point, that third point, the motion. So according to that motion, we are going to be developing the restrictions. Then automatically the reaction forces are going to be generating. Then how to assume the reaction forces, either upward direction or downward direction, that's we are going to be say. The next one, how to use the equations of equilibrium. then we are going to be find out the unknown parameters. In this case, sigma f of x equal to 0, sigma f of y equal to 0, and sigma the moments are at the point of is equal to 0. By this way, we are going to calculate. So the thank you, and we are doing the series of videos to follow and to understand completely this engineering mechanics, and that we are learning how to see these the engineering mechanics is going to be existed in the society. That means the engineering problems. So the please follow my channel so that series of videos we can see, then we can gain the knowledge about it.